Hi, my name is Phoebe He. I am a curriculum developer at Oracle. In the previous demo, you have learned what SOA Governance is. In this demo, I will show you how SOA Governance can be implemented by using Oracle Enterprise Repository. This graphic shows where Oracle Enterprise Repository, OER, fits into the SOA Governance framework. OER helps to define organization roles and responsibilities. It is mainly used in design time, and it supports runtime governance. During design time governance, OER can help to create reference architecture and service capability catalogs, as well as define standards. During runtime governance, by working with Oracle Web Services Manager and Enterprise Manager, OER can implement deployment, testing, provisioning, and exception handling frameworks. It also enables continuous integration through asset harvesting. OER provides enterprise-wide governance of assets, projects, and overall SOA initiative. OER's asset management function provides the means to centrally manage the metadata for any type of software asset, from business processes and web services to patterns, frameworks, applications, and components. It interacts with runtime components to get information on metrics, such as service reuse, to assist with the design time decisions. From this central repository, you can also map the relationships and interdependencies that connect software assets to the SOA and connect the SOA to business objectives. Asset management must therefore include tools and metrics to measure and communicate both compliance with governance policies and the ROI of the SOA transformation effort. OER also allows organizations implement existing role-based access control model and therefore limit access to asset based on user role. In a word, OER is central to SOA governance. Let's take a closer look on how assets are managed by OER. At design time, the command line and script-based harvester tool can publish assets, such as WSOs, XSDs, web services, and so on, from local or remote file systems. You can also discover and publish assets by connecting to a host server, such as Oracle SOA Suite. Developers consume the framework and other prescribed assets and use this to implement the composite service. A typical composite implementation includes people components along with supporting WSO and schema files. The composite service is deployed to the SOA infrastructure. Configuration metadata, MDS, hosts the sources of composites to configure and run the application. For example, it hosts the composite XML, which is used to implement the application. The main roles that use OER are developers, architects, IT managers, and business managers. Developers use OER to share, reuse, and engage with the developer community. Architects use OER to manage and optimize the enterprise architecture. Managers use OER for service management and measurement that are aligned to your business strategy. This is OER's architecture. OER is essentially a single Java process. Users mainly use web browser to work with OER. Command line tools and IDE are also used for certain tasks, like harvesting. Database is connected for information storage, and email notifications will be sent for changes in this repository. This is how it looks from user's perspective. Web console is a primary interface for users to find and consume assets and perform administrative tasks. The asset editor is used to administer assets and to configure the resources that associated with assets, such as value list, categories, and relationships. The type manager controls the organization and display of information for each asset type as it appears in the asset editor and in the web console. Policies and compliance templates are specialized asset types that you can also configure with the type manager. The import-export tool is designed to enable the interchange of assets and related metadata between instances of OER. Besides graphic tools, OER also has command line tools like Harvester, EM Utility, and Workflow Utilities to harvest, import metrics, and customize OER workflows. In a summary, with OER, you can configure, automatically publish and update repository content. OER provides role-based visibility to all SOA assets. This enables developers to easily harvest, locate, and consume SOA assets. You can graphically display and navigate relationships and interdependencies to simplify impact analysis and ensure business alignment. You can assign and approve assets across deployment, test, staging, and production. You can also enable automatic notifications of any changes. OER provides advanced capabilities, such as express workflows, policies, contracts, and more. OER can demonstrate the ROI from SOA with more than 20 out-of-the-box reports to show savings, track compliance, and illustrate SOA progress. Hopefully, you now understand what is Oracle Enterprise Repository and how it can help with SOA governance. I'm Phoebe He. Thanks for watching.